Hello everyone, and welcome to Series Catch Up. So this is going to be a new series on my channel in which every month in 2020 I read a backlist series that I've started but not completed, chosen by you. So in today's video, I'm going to be going through all the series / companion novels that I have started at some point in my life and haven't completed. These are all series I still have some sort of interest in, other series I've certainly unhauled, and once I go through all these series, you guys can comment down below what series you think I should be reading in February, and then I will vlog that experience for you in February based on whatever series gets the most votes, and we will continue it like that. Usually voting would take place in my vlog that I will post at the end of every month. Obviously January there's no vlog. I had a lot of different stuff going on this month, and also I wanted to catch up with A Curse So Dark and Lonely, which is a series I read this month and I will be talking about in a future wrap-up. But for every month coming forward, I'm going to let you guys choose the series that I'm going to be reading that month, because as I've mentioned multiple times, I have lots of series and there's plenty that needs to be done. To state before, I actually only have 7 series that I currently own to some extent that I've started that are actual series, and then I have 5 sort of companion series that I've started and not completed, and then only 9 of these series or companions I actually own the next book. So that's all basically the details of it. I have technically 12 series here, but I think in the middle of the year, once I for sure finish those 7 series that I would consider real series, I'm going to post a video that has all of the series that I currently own or the books that I have the first book in a series on my shelf, so you guys can still pick a series that I plan to read every month, because whenever I finish these, I want to post that video and then you guys can pick a series that I'm going to be reading in that month. And I'm really excited for this because while I can't have an entire video, people pick every single book I read in a month, I just don't think it would work for me. I like the idea of you picking a few books or a series like this that I need to complete, that I really want to complete, and have that motivate me to read this series. Unfortunately, a lot of these series, I also have to reread the first books or at least read some very thorough synopses. So that's also going to be a time. But without further ado, I'm going to get into the series that I have started but not completed that you are going to choose what I read for February. Yay! Okay, I hope I explained that well. If not, be sure to comment down below and ask any questions. Comment for your favorite series once I go through them, and let's just get into it. So starting off, I have a series that was one of my absolute favorites in 2016 or 2017. I honestly don't recall exactly. And that is the Illuminae series by Jay Kristoff and Amy Kaufman. If you don't know what this series is about, it follows this girl and this guy who recently broke up and their planet just got destroyed by these invaders, and they're sent off on these 2 different ships, so they're separated, and one ship is severely damaged and they're trying to escape the people that are coming to attack them, and this past couple kind of works together. It's so good. I would not recommend this enough. Like I said, it's still in this like multimedia format. And obviously I loved it. Like, this is like one of the first books I tabbed, and I would love to like read through it again with like all my tabs and see like what I liked. It makes me so emotional. So yeah, I've read Illuminae and I've read Gemina, but I never got around to reading Obsidio for some reason. And at this point I really enjoyed the reading experience with these, and while rereading the first 2 books would not be something that would help my TBR or break down my TBR, I feel like it would still be a really fun experience to read all 3 of these in the same month and just really get the full experience of it. And I've been really craving like this multimedia format because I haven't read it anything like these in a really long time. If you want me to read this in February, comment down below. If you want to save it for a future month, that's cool too. Just keep a watch out for the future videos and vlogs in the series, and you can vote there in the future. But I'm going to keep like a running list of like what everyone votes for. The next series I have here is a true classic, and that is Harry Potter. So for Harry Potter, I don't see the need in rereading the first couple books, mainly because I feel like Harry Potter does a really good job of recapping what happened in the last books in the beginning of the next book I read. So I've read the 3 shortest ones. So I have 4 left to go, which obviously would be a huge feat for 1 month, but I'm willing to give it a try, especially between reading physically and reading audiobooks. Obviously, most libraries, my library, has all these books in audiobook, and I know these are like really huge, so I'm just putting it out there that I am in college until May, and while I know everyone wants me to read this series, I'm getting out in May. So just keep that in the back of your head, you know? I'm getting out in May. It's a bit kind of a lot to read in school. So maybe just keep this for a future month. I don't know. I'm really excited to read it though. I'm excited to finish the series. And if you watched my 5-star predictions, you might have seen that I want to read Percy Jackson in the upcoming months, and that would kind of replace this and like classic stories that everyone's read. So Harry Potter is a series that I need to catch up on. The next series that I need to catch up on is the Shatter Me series. You may not know, but the Shatter Me series trilogy was originally a trilogy. It was Shatter Me, Unravel Me, and Ignite Me. Fantastic trilogy. I finished it in 2015 or 2016. Absolutely adored it. And then they kind of dropped this bombshell on us that there's gonna be more in the series, and I never got around to picking it up. I think this first book, Restore Me, came out in 2017, maybe? Or 2018? 2018, it looks like. And I never just got around to reading it because I heard like questionable things about it. And you know, when Woody Novels says that it's I'm like, maybe I shouldn't read it. So this is a series I want to catch up on. I don't plan on rereading the original trilogy just because this came out so much farther after. I feel like they have to recap to some extent what happened in the first three books. And I feel like this might also take place in the future. I don't know. It might not. Who knows? But I feel like when they know that the first three books came out way before, they kind of have to do some sort of recap in this. So for the purpose of this, I would read Restore Me, and then I would read Shadow Me, which is 4.5. Defy Me, which is full-length novel 5. Reveal Me, which is 5.5 novella. And then Imagine Me, which comes out March 31st, 2020. So if you choose this one, that's what you're choosing. That's what you're getting yourself into for a vlog. That would be a time. Once again, that's a lot of novels. So I'm just saying, there's lots of months. There's lots of months to choose. Just be nice to me, please. The next series we have is a series I still question if I want to finish. But I think I'm going to do it. So I'm going to show it to you guys today. And that is the last two books in The Mortal Instruments. So I started The Mortal Instruments in 2015. I feel like I keep saying 2015 or 2016, but that's basically that. 2015 or 2016, I never finished it because it just wasn't it for me. Like, I wasn't drawn in. I read The Infernal Devices and I was obsessed with it. And I think I'm gonna try to reread that sometime this year when you guys give me enough space in my TBR to read that. I would like to read that. But the problem with this, it's been a long time. And I want to get the full experience of reading all of them at the same time. However, the problem with that is there are so many and they are ridiculously thick. And it's like, I mean, it's kind of the same thing with Harry Potter, except these are like humongous books. I don't think I could do it in a month. And they're like, once again, this is a very popular series, so there's audiobooks for like all of these books. But I'm thinking I might just have to read the last two. So if you're voting for this, you're definitely voting for the last two. Maybe you'll get a surprise. Maybe I'll read the whole series in a month. We'll see if that happens. But this is something that I really want to finish, mostly because I'm interested in the next books, like the next series. I'm really interested in reading The Dark Artifices. If you want me to read it in February, let me know. If you want to save it, let me know. You get the idea. The next series I have is the Three Dark Crowns series by Kendar Blake. If you don't know what this series is about, it's about these three triplets that have to fight to the death for the throne, and they each have a different power. So one of them is an elementalist, one is a poisoner, and one is a naturalist, and they fight to see who is crowned. So I have read Three Dark Crowns and One Dark Throne. Pretty satisfied with both of them. I feel like I probably could reread them. I think audiobooks are at least available for the first book. And I feel like that could be beneficial, but I don't know if it's necessary because I feel like I'd honestly get more benefit out of reading a full synopsis, because when I first read these books, I was honestly pretty confused, and I feel like I'd be probably just as confused again if I read them. So I could read some pretty good synopses. And then there is two books and one novella that I would still have to read. So the novella actually takes place before The Happenings, but I'm pretty sure you're supposed to read it after the second book. So that is Queens of Fenburn. And then I have Two Dark Reigns, and then the final book in the series, Five Dark Fates, which I don't currently own, but I would buy for the purpose of this video. So three books really, two books and one novella I would have to read in 1 month. Pretty doable, not too bad about this one. And this is a series I've been really wanting to finish. It was one of my favorites, 2016 or 2017, maybe? I'm pretty sure I read this in my freshman year of college. I would love to finish this soon. I haven't really been keeping up if people liked the last couple of books, but I'd love to finish it. And yeah, the next series I still have to finish is the Lux series by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I read the first book, Obsidian, last year, 2019, and I never got around to finishing the second book in this like bind up, which is Onyx. And then after that, there is three more books, Opal, Origin, and Opposition. So if you chose me to finish this series, it would be reading four books in a month. I know there's like also like another like novella that's written like the first book in Damon's perspective, who was our main love interest. I'm not counting that because I never really was interested in that, and that doesn't seem like really part of the series to me. That's kind of like just like cash grab, just in my opinion. So that'd be four books. If you don't know what this is about, it's about this girl who moves to this West Virginia town, and she is like a book blogger, and she moves into this house that lives next to aliens, and there's like this whole plot line with like aliens. I don't think I'd reread this. I'd probably just look up another synopsis. And it was really fun. I really enjoyed it, so I'm excited to finish this at some point. And the last true series I have is the Archive series by Victoria Schwab. Yes, Victoria Schwab. And I read Archived in 2018, I believe, and I still have to read The Unbound. So if you choose this, I just have to read one book, it would be this one. I don't feel the need in rereading the first book, especially since I know the series will never be completed, but I really did enjoy the first book, and I'm still excited to read what happens to some of my favorite characters in the first book. So I'm still gonna be reading this. If you want, you can choose it for this month or a future month. And if you don't know what this is about this girl who manages this library where the dead sit on shelves like books, and she really controls the ones that wake up and are like roaming and can go out into the real world. She tries to keep them in this like library or in this space in between, and she's kind of like the guard keeper of that. It was a really fun first book. I'm really interested in the series still, so yeah. And then we're getting into more companion novels or books I wouldn't really consider a series, but they're listed as so on Goodreads, and I'm pretty interested in all of the future books in these companion series, so I would still like to catch up with them and read them. So first off, I read The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue in 2018, and I have yet to read the novella in between, which is The Gentleman's Guide to Getting Lucky, which was a pre-order incentive for The Lady's Guide to Petticoats and Piracy. So I would have to read one novella and one full story to complete this series. I'm not sure if there's any other books coming out in the future. Oh, there is. In August, apparently, there is going to be a third book in the series, which I had no idea, The Nobleman's Guide to Scandals and Shipwrecks. So if you chose this after August, I could read it then. But once again, it doesn't matter when you choose it. I'm gonna read it anyway. So I don't even know who this follows. I don't know this person. With all that knowledge, there you go. This is another series I have to finish at some point. The next series I kind of started, once again, standalone, that was The Kiss Quotient by Helen Huang. I already own The Bride Test by Helen Huang, which is the next book in the Kiss Quotient series. Like I said, once again, they're standalones that each follow different characters. They might have some sort of crossover at some point, but I've never really read like romance like series, which I'm pretty sure it's just like each book follows like a different character. But I have this, I've been dying to read it. I have it on ebook, I got it as an ARC. Never got around to it, who's surprised? There is another book slated in the series, but it's not coming out to 2021, so it doesn't matter. So for this, I would just be reading one extra book, which would be The Bride Test. So if you'd like me to read The Bride Test in the future, keep it in mind. And for these next three companion novel series, I actually don't own any of the next couple books, so keep that in mind. But the next series I have is the My Lady Jane series, or the My Lady Janies. The second book being My Plain Jane, which follows Jane Eyre, and there is a third book slated to come out in June 2020, and that follows Jane Calamity. Don't know who that is. So if you pick it now, I'll read My Plain Jane's, I'll buy it, I'll listen to an audiobook, I think it might be on audiobook, and if you pick it after June, I'll read the next two. Pretty simple. These are just like kind of funny books that follow like famous Janes in history, and they kind of rewrite the history. This one had a fantasy twist. I don't know if all of them have that, but really exciting and a really lovely series that I absolutely adored. The next two are series I really don't even know if I would consider series, but I'm putting it on here. I'm putting it into your hands. And that first series is the Dimple and Rishi series by Sandy Manon. I read the first book, When Dimple Met Rishi, and there are two full-length novels and one novella that comes after this. So we have 1.5, as Kismet would have it, a novella. And then there's two, There's Something About Sweetie, another book that I've heard really good things about and is out there. And then a third book is set to come out in June, and that is 10 Things I Hate About Pinky, which is technically the third book in the Dimple and Rishi series. I think this is kind of similar to like romance books where it follows different characters that are kind of side characters in the book before. You get the idea. I don't own any of these three. It looks like as Kismet would have it, is really short. Yeah, 60 ebook pages, so I get that ebook, and then the next two I would just have to pick up in some way or another. And yeah, if you want me to read that sometime soon, let me know. And then the last series that I have is Simon versus the Homo Sapiens Agenda, which is technically in the Creekwood series, and the second book in that would be Lee on the Offbeat, which came out in 2018, so pretty old. Never picked it up, but if you want me to read that book, feel free to comment down below. And with all that said, these are the 12 series that I would like to read in 2020, and it is in your hands for when I read them. So hopefully you stayed around this long, and you can now comment down below what you would like me to read in February. If you want to put some like a list of like your February to December rankings, feel free to do that as well. That could be really fun if you're like, oh, I want her to read this and during this time. I'd love that. But if not, just read what you want in February, give some other suggestions. But I will say that if I'm particularly feeling one of these series, I might throw it into a different month and maybe double up sometimes, just so I can get some of these out of the way, so I can start new series at a quicker time, and we can start reading some new series that I haven't read on my shelves, and I feel like that can make this really fun, so keep that in mind. But like I said, I will have a vlog at the end of February, and then in that vlog you can vote for the next month's pick, and it's gonna be a really fun time. I'm really excited, and the reason I'm doing it this kind of early is because I'm leaving for college in a couple weeks, and I need to know which books I'm bringing. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed this idea. I hope you're excited for this new series. And thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. Bye!